Rama's exile. When Rama heard about Queen Kekai's desires, he gladly accepted the news of his banishment. He tried to convince his father that it was a great honor for him to be sent to the forest because there he would meet many different sages and learn the meaning of sadness and happiness. He then took the blessings of Dashrath and Mother Kekai and went to meet his mother Kausalya. Hearing about Kekai's boons, Kausalya cried out loud, "How can you bear the hardship of living in a forest for 14 long years?" Rama smiled and assured her that 14 years would pass very quickly. As Rama began preparing for his departure, his wife Sita came to him. She begged Rama to take her with him, but he refused. Sita replied, "My lord, not being with you for 14 years will be greater hardship. My duty is to be by your side always." Just like Sita, Lakshman too decided to follow in the footsteps of his brother. "How can I leave my dear brother to face the dangers all by himself?" he argued. Seeing Sita and Lakshman's determination, Rama had no choice but to agree to their wish. Rama and the Ferryman. Moving from Ayodhya, Rama, Sita and Lakshman reached the banks of river Ganga. There they saw a ferryman and asked him to row them across the river. But the ferryman refused to offer his boat, saying that due to the touch of Rama's feet, a rock was changed into a lady, Ahilya. He told that he feared that due to Rama's touch, his boat would change to another woman, and thus his only source of earning would be lost. He suggested to wash their feet before allowing them to enter his boat. Rama smilingly agreed to this. After washing their feet, the ferryman collected the water drained from their feet. He drank some of this water and gave the remaining water to the members of his family to drink. He then rowed them across the river. Sita offered a gold ring to the ferryman as his fees, but he refused to take it, saying that he did all that because he had identified the Lord. He said that he was blessed to serve the Almighty. He also told that he had attained salvation as he was able to drink the water that touched the feet of Rama, Sita and Lakshman. Rama in Valmiki's ashram. Crossing the Ganga, they went to Prayag and met sage Bharadwaj, who welcomed them warmly. Staying there for a day, they moved forward. They met many people on their way. Everyone was pleased to see them. They reached the ashram of sage Valmiki, the creator of epic Ramayana. The ashram was located at a beautiful place, surrounded by mountains, forests and waterfalls. There were many birds and animals around the ashram. Valmiki welcomed them in the ashram and greeted them. He said that he was blessed that the Lord along with his wife had arrived at his ashram. He offered them many fruits, tubers, sprouts and roots. They ate the food and took a rest for some time. Rama asked the sage Valmiki about a nice place in the forest where he could live with Sita and Lakshman in a cottage made of grass and leaves. Valmiki suggested him to go to Chitrakoot mountain where Rama could live peacefully. The mountain was inhabited by many great sages like sage Atri. The sacred river Mandakini flowed there. It was a beautiful mountain with a big variety of flora and fauna. So Rama, Sita and Lakshman started their journey towards Chitrakoot mountain. Rama in Chitrakoot. On reaching Chitrakoot, Rama, Sita and Lakshman took a sacred bath in river Mandakini. They liked the area around the river and decided to stay there. Hearing this, the gods took the form of tribal forest men and went to Rama accompanied by the divine architect Vishwakarma. They built two beautiful cottages for them using grass and leaves and returned to heaven. Many great sages visited them and spent some time with the Lord and returned. The tribal forest men carried many fruits, roots, tubers and sprouts and went to offer them to the Lord. Everyone was glad to have the sight of Lord Rama and Goddess Sita and also Lakshman, the incarnation of Lord Sheshnag. Chitrakoot had become even more beautiful due to the arrival of Lord Rama. A pleasant breeze blew and many birds sang melodiously. All the animals had started living in harmony with one another. Lakshman was fully devoted to Rama and Sita's service, so he never missed his family. Sita was also happy with her husband and had forgotten all the pleasures of Ayodhya. But Rama missed his family and kingdom a lot. This way, Rama, Sita and Lakshman were leading their life on Chitrakoot Mountain.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.